What's happening everyone, my name is Alex and welcome back. In today's video we are checking out a robot vacuum like no other. And when I say robot vacuum like no other, I mean it. There isn't anything else available on the market that's remotely close to this robot vacuum right here. So this is the Roborock Saros Z70. This is a robot vacuum that vacuums and mops, but when it comes across some socks that you left on the floor or some slippers that you left in the kitchen the previous night, it will do something different. It will open the top, a robotic arm will come out, the robot will pick up whatever socks you left on the floor, will take them away to a designated area, will come back and continue cleaning. It will do the same for those slippers that you left in the kitchen. I never ever imagined that I would be seeing something like this with my own eyes in my house. But there we have it. This right here is the most advanced robot vacuum that I got to see with my own eyes. Now, when it comes to robot vacuums, we've seen a lot of smart upgrades over the years, but the Saros Z70 feels like a step closer to the kind of intelligent home assistant we've all been waiting for. It's not just about the cleaning anymore. Thanks to its AI features, it maps your space in 3D with high-level precision, learns your habits, and even uses a robotic arm to organize small items around the house. And the best part? It keeps getting smarter the more you use it. It's like having a home robot that actually adapts to your life, not the other way around. Okay, so the AI-powered robotic arm here is called the OmniGrip. But first of all, let's talk about safety. So the robot vacuum has a sensor right here at the top, so if there is something above the robot, it will not open that OmniGrip, so it knows better. Once that robotic arm is open, it also has a variety of pinch sensors, so if it does pinch something, it will stop. But there is also a manual emergency stop button, so let's say that something gets caught in that robotic arm, there is a button right here, you press it and it will stop. So safety first when it comes to this robot vacuum right here, because as you know, we have pets, we have kids at home, so you do need a safe device. And this one is as safe as it gets. There are a couple of ways of using the OmniGrip. The first way, and basically the easiest way, is to let the robot do everything by itself. So when this goes on a cleaning cycle, for example, it will stop when it comes across an object on the floor. It will recognize that object and it will also organize it. So it depends what it is. For example, if there are some socks, if there is a crumpled piece of paper, it will take that to a certain spot that you have designated on the map. Now, there is also this little bin that comes in the box, and you can have that for like paper and socks and stuff like that. And you can actually change the position of that on the map. I recommend that you select that somewhere in the middle, because otherwise the robot will have to go to the end of the house to drop off whatever item. So somewhere in the middle, somewhere central will be best, so it doesn't waste that much time going all the way to the end of the house to actually drop off an item. So once it recognizes an item, it will organize it. So if you have any slippers that you left on the floor, it will take those to the designated spot on the map as well. For now, it knows how to recognize and organize only a few items. So we have socks, we have sandals, we have crumbled paper and towels, like small towels, don't imagine like a big towel. Now, more items will be added in the future with software updates, so for now this is a beta version, so it's not available on the market quite yet. I believe there are a few more weeks till it becomes available on the market, so by then it could have other items added as well. So keep in mind, this will improve with time with software updates. But there is also a manual mode where you can actually play and interact with the robot manually from the Roborock app. So from the app, you can see the live view from the two cameras that the robot has. So we have one camera on the front here. You can also switch the view from this camera to the camera that we have on the OmniGrip. So at the top of the OmniGrip there, just before the grip, we actually have the camera, and we also have a couple of LEDs. Depending on the environment where the robot is, it will turn those LEDs on or off. So if it's a bright day out, it may not have those LEDs on, but if it's darker in that room, it will have those LEDs on. And basically from the app, you can actually move that robotic arm however you want. You can move it up, down, left, right, you can grip, you can open the grip. You can basically do anything manually if you want. So this is not only a robot vacuum, it becomes like a cool game because you're gonna be playing with the robot and picking up stuff from the floor, which I found myself doing just sitting on the couch there. So, of course, the easiest way to use this robot vacuum and the way it will make sense in your day-to-day life, basically, is having the robot vacuum do all the cleaning and also organize whatever you have left on the floor. Because that is the biggest problem with a lot of these robot vacuums. Before you start a cleaning cycle, you actually have to go around the house and make sure that you don't leave any socks on the floor, make sure that you don't leave any toys on the floor. Because if you have any of those on the floors, most vacuums will either get caught in those or they're not gonna be able to go in certain areas because there is something in front of them. Well, that problem is solved now because this one will basically move things out of the way and take them where they actually belong, and it will be able to clean wherever you had stuff on the floor. And leaving OmniGrip aside, this is actually a great robot vacuum and mop as well. Not to mention, it is extremely thin. So this has a height of 7.98 centimeters. So thinner than most other robot vacuums out there. So this one can easily go under furniture where a lot of robot vacuums cannot go. Because with a lot of robot vacuums you've seen, they are kind of high. Well, that's not the case with this one. This one can easily go under a lot of furniture throughout the house. You've probably noticed by now that this one doesn't have the typical LiDAR navigation system at the top like most robotic vacuums do. So this one, it's using what the manufacturer calls StarSight Autonomous System 2.0. So this one will be able to map out your entire house. It actually goes on a mapping cycle, let's call it, when you first set it up. So it knows exactly how every room looks like. It also knows exactly where it's been. It knows where it has to go. And of course, it knows how to go back to the docking station every time it needs to wash those mop pads, every time it needs to recharge and so on. But very importantly, it will also recognize objects on the floor and avoid those objects. If you open the Roborock app, once it's done a cleaning cycle, you can actually see on the map certain objects that it found on a cleaning cycle. And if it picked up something from the floor, you can actually see where it took whatever from the floor. So everything is done through the Roborock app, basically to interact with it. When it comes to suction power, the Saros Z70 has an insane suction power of 22,000 Pascals. So it doesn't matter what it goes over, it will suck anything up from hard floors or carpets. So a lot of suction power as well. As for the little brush on the side here, this one is retractable as well. So it can come out if it needs to reach a corner, but if it goes close to furniture, it can also hide in there and it will not catch any hair on it either. So I really appreciate that because I cannot stand having to clean the hair of those brushes constantly. Another feature that I find super useful is the ability to lift itself up. I haven't really seen this from any other robot vacuum up until now. So the manufacturer calls this adaptive lift chassis. So basically the robot vacuum will be able to lift itself up so it can go over obstacles easier. And in my case, and at my house here, I find this very useful so it can actually go in the bathroom because the floor in the bathroom is a bit higher than the regular floor. And a lot of vacuums have trouble actually getting over that threshold in between the regular floor and the bathroom floor. But that's not a problem for this one. So this one can go over up to 4 centimeters high, basically. So very interesting to see how it actually lifts itself up so it gets unstuck from certain areas, because there are certain areas in the house where a regular vacuum kind of goes with the belly on top of something and then it cannot lift itself up. It basically gets stuck in there. Well, that's not the case anymore with this, because this one can actually lift itself up, which is very, very unique. And talking about lifting, this robot vacuum can also lift the mop pads 22 millimeters. So that's important if the robot vacuum goes over carpet, so it doesn't actually touch the carpet with the mop pads. So it can actually detach those mop pads and leave them in the multifunctional dock. So if you're just sending this for a vacuuming session, it will actually detach the mop pads and leave them in the multifunctional dock and then it will come back to the dock, and if it needs to wash the floor, it will put those back on. And since we are talking about mopping, there is even more. So this is actually able to extend one of the mop pads, so it actually reaches the edge of the wall. With a lot of robot vacuums, they typically leave about this much space uncleaned. Well, that's not the case with this one. This one can actually get to the edge of the wall with one of those mop pads. So it extends the mop pad out of itself, if that makes sense. I'm showing you some B-roll so you can actually understand what I'm saying. But basically, you're not gonna have any space left unwashed. The multifunctional dock 4.0 is also the place where our robot vacuum will dock itself whenever it's not on a cleaning cycle. So in the multifunctional dock there, it will wash those mop pads with 80 degrees Celsius hot water. Whenever it's done a cleaning cycle, it will wash those mop pads and also dry them with 55 degrees Celsius hot air. Very important, because you don't want those mops to smell funny after a cleaning cycle. So that's not gonna be the case. It also empties all the dust inside the multifunctional dock, and basically you just have to fill up the water tank, the clean water tank at the top, and empty the other one that has the dirty water that gets collected from washing those mops, basically. So there isn't much that you have to do, is basically fill up that multifunctional dock with water and empty the dirty water every so often. And believe it or not, there is even more. If you don't want to use the Roborock app to control the vacuum, it even takes voice commands. So if you don't want to take out the phone, you can just say, hey, Rocky, go and clean the kitchen. And it will do all that by itself without you actually having to do anything on your phone.
Hello, Rocky.
Just vacuum.
Start vacuuming. Positioning. Standby.
So the Roborock Saros Z70 here is something else, something that we don't have anything remotely close to it. The Omni Grip here basically changes the way the robot actually cleans your house, because now you don't have to clean the floor before having the robot clean your floor, because that's what typically you have to do with most robot vacuums out there. Well, really all vacuums out there, because none of them can pick up stuff from the floor. As always, there will be some links in the video's description where you can check out the Roborock Saros Z70. But if you're looking for the most extreme robot vacuum out there, a vacuum that everyone that sees is mind blown about, you should see the people that come visiting and they see the robotic arm coming out. Nobody can believe their eyes. So if you're looking for the most advanced robot vacuum out there, look no further, because there isn't anything else remotely close to this one. Alright guys, if you do have any questions, feel free to leave some comments down below and I'll try to answer whatever questions you may have. Thanks Roborock for sponsoring this video, and I will see you guys in the next one.